I'm very, very excited to be here with you. Thank you so much, Renee, for having me here, and Superintendent Peake, thank you so much for having me here. I did not know very much about, I didn't know much about your school system before coming down here. And you go ahead and click that for me. And so Renee, when she invited me to come down here, I started stalking you. So I started reading articles about Mobile County Public Schools. I did know that you were the largest school district in the state. I did know that, but I didn't know much else. And so Renee shared with me that you guys started a social media campaign on the first day of school, and she told me your hashtag. It starts today. So I went on Twitter and I started checking out what had been tweeted about your school system, what your teachers were tweeting, what you guys were tweeting, what your parents were tweeting. And I'm going to tell you, I want to come back. I want to come back and visit several schools in your district because of what I saw on Twitter. Some of the academies that I saw were just incredible. What your teachers are doing in the classroom, the science that you're doing, just really, really neat stuff. And so that shows you a little bit about the power of Twitter. I didn't know anything about your school district, and now I'm full of information, and it's all positive about your school district. So I thought that was really cool that you started your school year with this hashtag. I thought it was cool, too, that I saw a picture of your superintendent in a classroom on the first day of school talking to kids. I thought that was really cool, too. So that told me a lot about what's going on in the school district. And so this morning, I'm going to talk to you about using social media to promote your school. And so why is that important, right? Does getting on Twitter and sharing your story with the world make you a better educator? Does it make you a better school leader? Does it make you better at doing your paperwork or doing your observations or handling the discipline? I want you to think about what you're going to be doing and why you need to share your story with the world. I love this graphic about using Twitter. And I want to share with you a little bit about my evolution as a Twitter user. And it really mirrors this almost exactly. So back in 2009, I left a principalship to go to Hoover High School, where I'm at now. And I went back to the classroom for 2 years before going back into administration. And around that time, I had been hearing about Twitter and hearing the great things about it. And I thought, well, what is this Twitter? Okay, so I set up an account, and I had been on Facebook and kept up with my friends that I knew from junior high, from elementary school, and I thought it was really cool. So I thought, let me check out this Twitter and see what it's got to offer. So I set up an account, and I tried it for a couple of months, but I couldn't keep up with it. Has anybody experienced that? You've gotten on Twitter, and you're like, what in the heck is going on? Yeah, you're lost. And so I was used to Facebook. I was used to seeing a post by someone and seeing threaded comments underneath. And so I could keep up with the conversation or the comments about those pictures. On Twitter, it's nothing like that at all. And so after a couple months, I thought, what? This is crazy. I'm not going to try this. And so I went on about my business. And after a couple months, I thought, okay, I keep hearing about Twitter. I want to try it. And so at that time, I found this family on Twitter. Their Twitter handle was Family on Bikes. And it was a family of four. It was two teachers, their sons, and they were biking from Alaska to Argentina. And I thought, this is really cool. And so I started following the mom who was doing the tweeting. I started following them in their journey. And I started to understand how conversations happen on Twitter because I would see her respond to someone else, and then I would click the tweet, and kind of figure out the thread on Twitter. I was back in the classroom. I was a science teacher. I was teaching biology. And here's a family that's in South America, and we're studying ecosystems in the classroom. So I thought, I'm going to see if this lady will Skype with us. I had never done anything like this before. I didn't know her. She was from across the country. I didn't know what she would say. She might think I'm crazy. I'd never Skyped with anyone like that before. I knew we had a good technology department, and I knew that they would come help me if she said yes. And she did. She said yes. So I was able, through the connection that I had made on Twitter, I was able to bring this family into my classroom virtually and share where they were, what they were seeing, what they were doing with my students in Hoover, Alabama. It was really cool. And that kind of lit the fire for me to learn more about Twitter. So fast forward to 2011, where I go back to administration and I'm assistant principal at Hoover High School. I'm still tweeting. I'm still, you know, I'm visiting classrooms now. I'm still tweeting about what's going on in the school. And I'm making connections with other professionals. And I will tell you that when I was an assistant principal prior to becoming a principal, and when I was a principal, I didn't have the connections that I have now. And it can feel really lonely at times because you think, is this happening in other schools? How are people dealing with this? What do they do in this situation? And sometimes it's hard to ask someone who's in your school or in your district. And now I have a network of people that I can call on at any time who are doing what I do and say, what would you do about this? Do you have any of these resources? Can you help me? And so through Twitter, I had that support system in doing my administrative job. So go to 2012, and our school is going to implement a one-to-one initiative. And so my colleague, Dr. Sutherland, Holly Sutherland, wanted to start tweeting. And so I started working with her and helping her figure out how to use Twitter. And so we decided that we would start tweeting from the classrooms as we visited them that year. And so up until that point, teachers were used to having administrators in their classrooms. They were a little ambivalent about it, though. But I tell you, that was the biggest culture changer in our school, because now when we were visiting classrooms, we were tweeting out what our teachers were doing, what our kids were doing. And our teachers started emailing us every day. Imagine getting an email every day from a teacher in your building who says, come see what we're doing today. Come see my kids. We're doing a debate today. Come see what my kids are cooking today. I'm going to try something new today. I don't know if it's going to work, but I would love for you to come see it. We had an experienced teacher who normally put her kids in rows, and she did all the talking. And that day she was going to try an app on the iPad, and she was going to try Quizlet with her kids. And so we went to see her, and it was a completely different classroom because of our one-to-one initiative, but she also invited us because she knew that we were proud of her and we wanted to share what she and her students were doing, and we're going to share it with the world. It's really been the coolest thing that I've seen happen in my 23 years in education, to see teachers invite administrators to their classrooms. It's been really, really cool. And so that same year, Holly and I thought, you know, there's several states around the country that are doing these ed chats. And so we thought, why not us? Two girls from Hoover, Alabama, we'll start Alabama Ed Chat. And so we did. And so every Monday night from 9 to 10, we get together with other educators from around the globe and we talk education. We love it. Everybody that you meet on Twitter wants to be there. You ever go to PD sessions? Not this one, but you ever go to PD sessions and some people don't really want to be there, right? Your mind's back on school and what's happening and what happened yesterday. People who are on Twitter want to be there. It's encouraging. People are enthusiastic and supportive. And so while I'm going to talk to you today about telling your school story, I also want you to keep in the back of your mind the personal benefits that you will get by connecting with other professional educators across the globe, okay? And so now, yes, it is a part of my life. It is a part of my life. I always think about tweeting something. I'm always snapping pictures and wanting to share what's going on in our school, what's going on in education, and just trying to be a positive influence on educators everywhere. And so while you may not be at the right end of the spectrum, you may be on the left end of the spectrum, that's okay. Because you remember, everybody starts somewhere, okay? So what I'm going to ask you to do right now, you're in your feeder patterns, so you know these people next to you. So I'm going to ask for a moment of vulnerability. I want you to turn and share something that you're fearful about when thinking about sharing your school story on social media. Turn and share. All right. Wow. Lots of fears, huh? And so I was just informed that you guys are not sitting in feeder patterns today. So maybe you met a new friend today. So maybe some of your fears look like you're afraid you won't have time to do it. You're afraid you're going to like it so much that it's going to take up all your time. You're afraid that somebody's going to follow you and they're going to post something inappropriate. You're afraid a student might post something inappropriate using your school hashtag. You're afraid you'll start it and won't finish. You'll start it and it will fizzle out. You're afraid to highlight a few teachers because you don't highlight everybody. You're afraid you're not going to even know how to start. You're afraid to even download the app. You've never downloaded an app before. Maybe that's your fear. I want you to look around this room because y'all are all in this together. We all share those same fears. Okay? So know that you're not alone. Have y'all seen this before? Have y'all seen this about fear? So we can choose to let fear take over, or we can choose to face our fears. And if you feel like the reason for sharing your school story is more compelling than your fear, it's time to face it. And know that you don't have to go down that road alone. This room right here is full of people who are here today doing what they can do to make things great for students in Mobile County Public Schools. And so you're all on the same page about that. Okay? So here's a video clip from Seth Godin. I'm not sure if you guys know him. He's an entrepreneur. Writer. This is a great little video clip I wanted to share with you.
So a year or so ago, you gave me a piece of advice that's really stuck in my head ever since. It means a lot to me. I want to know what it means to you. You said, Scott, keep making a ruckus. What does that mean?
I've been thinking a bunch about what it is that I do when I do my best work, and I want to tell two little asides. When my son was 6 years old, he climbed up a 12-foot diving board to jump off, but he got scared at the top, and he didn't jump off, and I wouldn't let him climb down because he climbed back up. So after half an hour, he finally jumped off, and what he did instantly was get back up onto the diving board to do it again. What happened? Why was it that the first time it was something he couldn't possibly do, and then he wanted to do it again, right? And the reason is that there is this moment that we have, this feeling that we get when we're about to do something that might not work. I think that feeling is what it is to be a human, what it is to make art, what it is to make a difference. And some people have never felt that feeling. So part of my job is to provoke people into feeling that possibility.
And so today I want to provoke you into feeling that possibility. My husband is terrified of snakes. And this summer, we did a lot of work in our yard, trimmed a lot of bushes. There's a creek behind our house. And so, there's been lots of snakes in the past. And he's very scared of them. And so the first day that we went out there and we were trimming the bushes and, cutting down weeds and pulling up stuff, he was nervous. And he did not want to go down there. And he just, very carefully and gingerly got down the rocks and got down by the creek and, you know, was constantly looking around for Mr. No Shoulders, as he calls him, to jump out at him, okay? So that's the first day. Yeah, that's the first day. You know what happened on the second day? He went right down there. He stopped looking around. He went right down there and got to work. And it's the same with this. The first time that we try something, the first time that we're doing something, we're nervous about it until we get comfortable. And then after that, we get better and better and better. We ask students of this every day. We ask them to try something new. We ask them to speak up. We ask them to advocate for themselves, to read out loud. We ask them to learn something new and try something new. And if we forget what that feels like, we're doing an injustice for our students. We've got to continue to push ourselves and try new things. And so here's a quote. If we don't tell our school story, somebody else will. You know what's happening inside your four walls of your building. You know the awesome things that are happening. You ever had parents tell something that wasn't true about what's going on in your school? Nah, not in Mobile, that's what I heard last night. You ever had the news media say something negative about your school, and that's the only story that's out there? So if you don't tell your story, somebody else is going to tell it, okay? Take a look at this tweet. Notice that hashtag. That's AL. So is that a very positive story about public schools in Alabama? Not at all. Is that the only story? Is that the only message that we want out there about our schools? No. There's a whole lot of awesome things that are going on in public schools. And if you're not a public school champion, you shouldn't be in this room right now. And if this doesn't infuriate you, you shouldn't be in this room right now. Because kids deserve better than this. Our public needs to know the hard work that we do every day for kids. And so I want to encourage you, take charge of the messages that you can control. Okay? All right. And I know this feels, sometimes can feel a little bit markety. You know, you hear branding your school. A lot of entrepreneurship principles in our society right now. But when you brand your school, that's what people are going to say about you when you're not around. What are parents going to say at the ballpark? What are they going to say at church? What are they saying in the grocery store? What are they saying at the dinner table? So we want the messages about your school that all of your stakeholders are sharing to be positive, okay? And so I wanted to share a little bit about what I want people to know about Hoover High School from Twitter. These are the four big areas. The one thing I want people to know about Hoover High School is that relationships are important. We show pictures of kids with teachers. The first 2 days of school this year, we started on a Thursday. The first 2 days of school this year, we committed to throwing out the syllabus. And so we tweeted about that. So if any of you guys follow me or have seen, followed our hashtag Hoover Pride, you saw that the first 2 days, we spent time building relationships. That's important to us because without that, learning isn't going to happen anyway. That's got to be there first. I bet that's what's important in your schools too. The second thing that I want people to know about Hoover High School is that there's lots of opportunities at our school. We've got fine arts. We've got athletics, we have academies, we have all kinds of opportunities for students to get involved, to be college and career ready. We offer dual enrollment, we offer AP classes, we have lots going on at our big high school. We want to share that with our public, with our stakeholders. The other thing about Hoover High School is that it's a big school. We've got about almost 3,000 students in our high school. And you know what comment most parents say when they first come to our school? God, this place is big. This is like a college campus. You don't hear them say, God, it's just so friendly here, you know? That's what they say. That's the first impression. And you know, we think that you can feel lonely even in a small group. And so we really encourage our students to get involved in a small group, whether that's on a team, whether that's part of a club. And let's not forget that group of 25 to 27 students in a teacher's classroom. That's a community. And so we want every classroom to be a small community where kids can connect with each other. That's important to us. And the last thing is that we want to be excellent. We want to share that, not just in football. We want to be excellent in academics. We want to be excellent in the arts. We want to be excellent in our clubs. Why would we post messages about mediocrity, right? So we post messages bragging on our students, bragging on our coaches, on our teachers, our administrators, our counselors. We want to be excellent all around. So what would you want others to know about you and your school? So everybody has a smartphone, right? Can y'all read this? If you take out your phone and you text Jennifer Hoga, 341, you're going to text that to 22333. And I want you to share, what do you want others to know about your school? What's your story? So take just a second, check your neighbor, make sure they know how to do this. 22333 is who you're texting to. What do you want other people to know about your school? Put it out there. Two, two, three, three, three is the number you're texting to. And you're going to text Jennifer Hoga without the N and the number 341. Uh-oh, something happened with that font. Let's see what's going on up here. I want people to know our academics are on par with any other school. I guess that was, there we go. Oh, go back. Nope, it'll show up. It should show up. Okay. There we go. That our teachers care about their children. I'm not sure what's going on with the font there, guys. There we go. Our school is a large community school with some of the best teachers and students in the district. Wow, that's awesome. Hankins is customer service friendly. Love that. Our focus is on building relationships so that we can impact student learning. We are family. We are Dawson. Blount High School is the number one healthcare academy in the district. What else? What do you want people to know about your school? What's your story? We are innovative. We are a community, scholarship through leadership. It's awesome. I want to come to your school and find out what you're doing to promote leadership in your school. We're a digital literacy and talents unlimited site. Our teachers are professional and dedicated. Collins Rhodes works hard but plays harder. Y'all, these are awesome. Think about what you just heard and read and shared. These are incredible messages. You guys have something really special going on in your district, in your school. Has anybody used this app before or this program? It's called Poll Everywhere. So if you are leading PD with your faculty, maybe a faculty meeting, this is a great way to get input from your staff. It's called PollEverywhere.com. Great way to get input. I appreciate y'all sharing these messages this morning, telling you this is awesome. All right. How hard was it to type that message? It wasn't hard at all, was it? It's easy to brag on your teachers. It's easy to brag on your students. And I'm going to tell you, I personally am compelled by this statement. It is incumbent upon us to tell our school story, not somebody else. Don't let the news tell your story. You tell your story. How about this statistic? 75% of parents are on social media. That doesn't mean necessarily Twitter, but they're on social media. Facebook, Instagram, maybe Tumblr. They're on social media, maybe Snapchat. Where else can you get 75% of your parents all in one place? I think that's pretty amazing. Huh? Go ahead. Okay, here's another statistic for you. Look how many Twitter users there are. And so when you tell your school story on Twitter, you're telling it to millions of people across the globe. Who knows where your story will end up? Who knows what opportunities that may bring for your students? 71% of online adults are on Facebook. We know this. Kids, it was started by kids. Parents started getting on Facebook. They left and went to Twitter. We started getting on Twitter. They went to Snapchat. And when we invade Snapchat, they'll go somewhere else. That's just the way that it is, right? And so when you're thinking about, you know, what am I going to share on Twitter? We're not talking like some amazing newsworthy story. When your news reporter calls and says, hey, we'd like to do a feature on your school, well, we try to think of something big and amazing for them to put in the news. There are a lot of day-to-day things that happen in your building that are amazing. Though, that's where the magic happens, when those moments happen every day. Not that they happen every once in a while, but magic happens every day for kids. And so I don't know if y'all have seen this video before, but I think it really speaks to what teachers believe about their classrooms, because you've seen those teachers who, you know, do incredible things every day, but for them, that's just what they do, and they do it every day. So they don't think of it as amazing.
Any creator of anything knows this feeling. You experience someone else's innovative work. It's beautiful, brilliant, breathtaking. You're stunned. Their ideas are unexpected and surprising, but perfect. You think, I never would have thought about that. How do they even come up with that? It's genius. Afterwards, you think, my ideas are so obvious. I'll never be as inventive as that. I get this feeling often. Amazing books, music, movies, or even amazing conversations. I'm in awe at how the creator thinks like that. I'm humbled. But I continue to do my work. I tell my little tales. I share my point of view. Nothing spectacular, just my ordinary thoughts. So one day someone emailed me and said, I never would have thought about that. How did you even come up with that? It's genius. Of course, I disagreed and I explained why it was nothing special. But afterwards, I realized something surprisingly profound. Everybody's ideas seem obvious to them. I'll bet even John Coltrane or Richard Feynman felt that everything they were playing or saying was pretty obvious. So maybe what's obvious to me is amazing to someone else. Hit songwriters in interviews often admit that their most successful hit song was one they just thought was stupid and not even worth recording. We're clearly a bad judge of our own creations. We should just put it out and let the world decide. Are you holding back something that seems too obvious to share?
So at Hoover High School, we're doing some pretty cool things. But we're not doing anything more cool than what's happening in the school district. The only difference is I'm sharing it with the world. Our teachers are sharing things with the world. Some of your schools, you're doing that too. Don't think that because it's something that you just do on a routine basis, that's just who we are. You need to share that, okay? Because it is amazing. And so, you know, at our school, we celebrate teachers of the quarter, staff members of the quarter. And I say we need to celebrate teachers of the moment. I mean, there's stuff that happens all the time in classrooms everywhere. Our public does not know about that. Your stakeholders, they just don't know. We've got to pull back that curtain and allow them a peek into your school so that they'll know what's happening. Some teachers are better than this at others. Some teachers send home a real comprehensive newsletter every week to their parents, or they have a private Facebook page for their parents, and they do a lot of sharing. Some teachers, this is an area of growth for them. As a school leader, you can help everyone. And so I also believe this, that to tell a school story, you have to have engaged leaders. So I've got another poll for you. What does it mean to be an engaged leader? So just use that same texting thread. What does it mean to you to be an engaged leader? Someone said in constant contact with what your teachers and staff are doing. Leading by example. Love that. Involved and visible. Engaged leader knows what the pulse of the school truly is. It's a great quote by Gandhi, "Be the change you want to see." We've got to model what we want to see. Visible's up there again. Teachers want that from leaders. They want them to be out and about in classrooms, in hallways, at the buses, at carpool. Sincerely involved in what matters to children and teachers. That's good. Let me ask you this. If you're not engaged as a leader, can we ask our teachers to be engaged? The challenge question for you. Just a little pushback, something for you to think about. Those are great responses. And I also want to say to you, you do not have to have it all figured out to get started. Maybe you don't even have the app on your phone. You're not sure what to do. You're not even sure what a tweet looks like. You don't even know how to pick a Twitter handle. You don't know how often you would be able to tweet. You don't know, you don't even have Facebook. Heck, you still have a flip phone. Okay? Not that there's anything wrong with flip phones. But we're talking about moving forward, right? Okay. So I've got a plan for you I want to share, and it's about telling your school story in four steps. So these are the four things that I want you to think about when you tell your school story, okay? It's got to be targeted. We're going to talk about what that means. You've got to show enthusiasm. I know that y'all don't walk into PD with your teachers, walk into staff meetings with your shoulders slumped, with a scowl on your face, and looking like you wish you were somewhere else, right? So you want to be enthusiastic. You also want to share the little things. The little things that people think are just obvious, share those. And you can't have a school without love. And so you need to show how much love is in your building. So what does it mean to be targeted? We're going to talk about using a hashtag in your tweets. How many of you guys have a school hashtag for your school? Raise your hand. I want to see who has a school hashtag. If your hand is not up, I want you to write that on your to-do list right now. Create a school hashtag. Well, what is a hashtag anyway, right? That's what some of you guys are asking. What's a hashtag? I want you to think of a hashtag like a cable channel. So if you go to HGTV, you know what kind of TV shows you're going to get on HGTV. If you go to ESPN, you know what kind of TV shows you're going to get on ESPN. If you go to hashtag Hoover Pride, you know that you're going to get tweets about Hoover High School. I knew that if I went to hashtag It Starts Today, I was going to see tweets about Mobile County Public Schools. So a hashtag allows others to find your tweets because you can search by hashtags. Okay? Go ahead. I love this tweet. So I'm right out of college. I went to South Alabama. I want to stay in the Mobile area. I'm an awesome teacher, and I want to find a job, and I see this tweet from the superintendent of Mobile County Public Schools. You know what? I want to work in that school district. I'm a parent in the community. Pardon?
Just name where you'd like
to. Let's say I'm a parent in the community. I'm a parent in the community, and I see this tweet from the first day of school. Oh my gosh, the superintendent is at my child's school? And look, she's laughing. She is having fun with the kids. That must be a really special place because it starts at the top, right? What starts at the top is going to filter down. I thought this was awesome. And she has the hashtag, It Starts Today. Here's another tweet from your school district. I guess this was maybe a handout that you got early on, maybe one of those first institute meetings, something like that. And I love it. So whoever's at this elementary school put add Dawson, their hashtag, to those tweets. I love that. Dawes Intermediate. Love it. Here's another hashtag, Kane Nation. So how cool that parents, community members, they can actually see a video clip of a pep rally at this school. So cool. And so if I search for Kane Nation, I can find tweets about this school. Very cool. So I thought this was really neat too. I'm a former science teacher. I love seeing kids doing science, not just reading about science. And so this one has the hashtag Austin Innovators. Love this. And so how do you go about getting a hashtag? Like, is that assigned to you? Is that something you have to apply for? How does that work? So all you're gonna do on Twitter is if you have a hashtag that you think you wanna use for your school, you're just going to enter it in the search bar. Whatever you think your hashtag might be, enter it in the search bar with the hashtag in front of it and see if there are any other tweets using that hashtag. And if there are a lot of tweets that use that same hashtag, you probably want to use a different hashtag. So find one that nobody else is using or very few people are using and just declare it your hashtag. Tell everybody, this is our new school hashtag. Tell it everywhere that you can. And I love this. I don't know what elementary school this parent is going to. Oh my gosh. I thought this was so cool, and it shows you how far-reaching your hashtag can be. This is a parent walking his son to kindergarten, and he used your district hashtag. Isn't that cool? It's really special. And so not only do we want it to be targeted and use the school hashtag, you also want to be enthusiastic. How do you show enthusiasm? Can you read tone in a text? Can you read tone in a tweet? Let's see. I don't know if this assistant principal is in the room today, but I saw this. You know, he added with his hashtags, I don't think this particularly means this is their school hashtag, but he put a hashtag that said Proud AP. Sometimes people will use hashtags for emphasis on something, and I just thought, how neat is that, that these middle school and high school cheerleaders work together at the football game. He was there, and he was very proud of them. Thought that was really cool. So at this elementary school, their hashtag is Our Hut, and they're thanking this martial arts group for a generous fundraiser. It's a great way to reach out to your community, great way to publicly thank supporters of your school. The picture's a little bit dark, but those kids are really, really excited. It was a neat picture. Okay, how about this? You can hear the enthusiasm in this tweet. What a great student section, best student section around. Great job, Bobcats. This is a little video clip of the student section at the football game. That was awesome. And this was pretty powerful. So who's Michael's sentence? Our state superintendent of education. And he's congratulating a teacher who won a national award, who's in your school district. You should be proud. And our state superintendent is saying, congratulations. Hashtag inspirational. That is amazing. Must be doing some really great things in that school. How about this? Isn't this just a little thing that a lot of people may not know about, but this teacher's really excited. You know, we're excited to be the PE class of the week. It pays to follow the rules. The kids are excited. They have a trophy. That's pretty cool. And so that leads us to the little things. What are those little things that are often overlooked that make a school run? There are lots of people that make a school run. How about this? If you're a parent and your child goes to this school, you want to know that they're safe and that they're happy, right? Yes. This is awesome. So the lunch lady's wearing a t-shirt that said lunch lady because awesome is not an official job title. How good does that make you feel as a parent when you know that your kids are going to school with somebody who's passionate about her job like that? So here's something that probably most classrooms do, K-12. We did it in our school. Our teachers planned activities to get to know kids. And in this school, they use those little brown bags where kids put something about themselves in their bags and then they shared it with the classroom. This is the kind of stuff that won't make it to the news, but this is something that you can share with the world on Twitter. You don't have to wait for the news reporter. You can share this. Love that. How about this? The kids in this school are smart. The teachers in this school are smart. That's what this whole tweet says. What does a scientist look like? Well, look in the mirror. You're the scientist. You're the engineer. You're the president. You're the CEO. You're the teacher. You're the NFL player. You're whatever you want to be. That's what this message says. We teach our kids to dream. And that's a little thing. Looked like it was in the hallway, maybe. How about this? A perfect score at Mary B. Austin Elementary. They had a perfect score in the lunchroom. That's awesome, too. That's a little thing that you can share. And I want to come back and I want to visit. Who's from Rain High School? Anybody?
Yes.
I want to come to your school. I want to learn about the aerospace engineering program. I looked at a lot of stuff about that. That is awesome. Who knew? And they went to a startup weekend, like for entrepreneurs, where they pitched their ideas, and they were finalists. It's amazing. And without love, a school's not going to run. That comes first. I think this tweet was from the spring, and it says, "Meet our future business and community leaders." And the Twitter handle for this school is Griggs Stars. That's neat. And I love this too. Thank you to our custodial staff. You know, a school to me is like the inside of a clock. Everybody has a specific job to do, and everybody contributes to the success of that school. So you've got all these moving parts. Everybody's got to do their job to make it work. And so here, we didn't overlook anybody. Our custodians, who sometimes are overlooked, they're being thanked for keeping it in tip-top condition. Kids want to go to clean schools. Parents want their kids to go to clean schools. And I thought this was great, too. As a former coach, I love seeing this when athletes, high school athletes, go down and visit elementary school athletes. Elementary school students, because you know those elementary students look up to those high school athletes, and for them to take the time and go down there and spend some time with them, that says a lot. And how about this? This is a student-run Twitter account, and it says, "If you can't afford a homecoming dress, see this person for dresses." And then they ask people to donate. Little things like that are important. This shows that students care about each other. Our teachers care about our students. Excuse me. And so, how am I doing on time? Okay. And so, I want to share with you a few just kind of nuts and bolts, practical kind of tips. Okay? So, here's a plan if you're just getting started on Twitter. 5 by 5 by 5. How many of y'all have been to a PD workshop, went there one time, that was all you heard about it, you never implemented it, you never did anything with it, it was one and done? Anybody been to one of those? I have. I bet you have too. And so one and done's don't work. If you're going to try to lose weight, you can't just diet on one day and lose the weight. If you're going to run a marathon, you can't go out and run one time and then be ready to run the marathon. And the same is with Twitter. You need just a little bit every day. So if you're new on Twitter, this is how I want you to start. I want you to only follow 5 people. Don't follow 100, follow 5 people. And for 5 days, I want you to spend 5 minutes on Twitter. No more, just 5 minutes for 5 days. After those 5 days, you can spend a little more time on Twitter, and I want you to start retweeting, I want you to start interacting, I want you to start sharing, because there's lots of good stuff that happens on there. And if you try to jump in too quickly, I'm afraid it'll be overwhelming. It'll be like trying to drink from the fire hose. Okay? So just 5 minutes a day for 5 days and follow 5 people. Well, who do you follow? Look around. Those people who are on Twitter who are in this room, who do they follow? Check and see who they follow. Follow those people. See who I follow. See who your superintendent follows. Find people who do what you do. Find people who are positive, inspirational, people that you can learn from. That's who you want to follow. Okay? But it just takes a little bit each day. Don't think that I'm on Twitter a lot. But don't think that I'm on there 24/7, okay? There's lots of little tricks that you learn as you use it, okay? And I want to teach you some of those tricks. Who has time to spare? If you do, I want to talk to you too before I leave. Nobody has time to add anything on their plate, right? Did anybody have time to take a shower today? Did anybody have time to brush their teeth this morning? Yeah? Some of y'all may have found time to work out or run this morning. Anybody? And so y'all know this. We make time for what we like. We make time for things that are important. So if you're saying, I don't have time to tweet, I bet you've got a couple of extra minutes here and there that you can spare to tell the world about your school. We're talking a few minutes to tell the world about what you're doing in your school, okay? So part of a leader's job is to be visible. Part of a school leader's job is to visit classrooms. While you're there, tweet what's happening. Kill two birds with one stone. Take your phone with you, take your iPad, take your device. While you're there, tweet what you're seeing. Let the teacher see that that's what you're doing. Tell them as you're leaving, hey, I tweeted you. Tell them later when you see them in the lunchroom, hey, I tweeted you this morning. Did you see it? Okay. Maybe you get to school 15 minutes earlier, and that's when you get on Twitter. You read some of those blog posts that are shared. You read some articles. You catch up on your school hashtag. Maybe you set aside 15 minutes before school. Maybe you say, every afternoon, I'm going to spend 5 minutes when everybody's gone before I leave, and I'm going to check Twitter. Okay? Maybe you're waiting for parents to arrive for a meeting. So while you're waiting, you're just sitting and waiting for them to arrive, that's when you can tweet some things that are happening. So as you're going to bus duty or as you're walking around the building, snap some pictures. Maybe teachers have a motivational poster in their classroom. Maybe the library has a bulletin board in the hallway that you can take a picture of. Maybe there's a new trophy from the Scholars Bowl team. And so while you're waiting for parents to arrive for a meeting or a teacher to arrive, that's when you can tweet. Okay, tweetdeck.com is a resource that's one of my top four resources. And the one reason that I love it is because I can schedule tweets. I told you about Holly Sutherland and I, the first year that she started tweeting. She tweeted a positive quote every morning of a school year. So she would say, like, day number one, and she'd have a motivational quote. She did that every day. Now, did she come in every morning and type that every morning? No. She scheduled it on TweetDeck so she could pre-schedule some tweets to go out. You can too. So instead of sending 20 tweets out at once, you can schedule them to go out several times during the day. Okay? Maybe it's a day like today when you're not in the building. You can pre-schedule those tweets to go out. And so it looks like you're there in the building. You're taking pictures. You're sharing what's going on in your building. And some of that downtime that you might have, whether it's just a few minutes here or there that you get, that's time that you can get on Twitter and make an impact. And then what do I tweet? Here are some ideas. I'm going to share this presentation with Renee so that you'll have this. But once you start tweeting, you're going to be able to add to this list. If you have author visits in your building, take pictures of that. Share quotes from your students, especially high school students. I think that's pretty powerful. Share quotes from your students. Share quotes from teachers. Maybe when your teachers are learning, maybe they're in a workshop, take pictures of that. Your nurses that take care of your kids, smiling secretaries, bookkeepers, custodians, lunch ladies, take pictures of them. Share that with the world. Classroom decor, I'm telling you, that is a great thing to share because it might start conversations with your parents and your community, but it also may start conversations between teachers. I don't know about y'all, but in our high school, not every classroom is decorated. Some classrooms look kind of like this room. There's not really much on the walls, not really much to look at. It's not very welcoming. And so that allows us to start having conversations because even though I get to visit every classroom in the building, some of our teachers don't visit other teachers' classrooms and they don't see what their classrooms look like. Through Twitter, they can see this. And so what if you're saying to yourself, well, I started Twitter last year, but I only have 25 people who follow me. Nobody's going to see my tweets. Well, it is important to get a few more followers. Let your parents know, hey, here's my Twitter handle. I'd love for you to follow me. Follow Dawes Intermediate. You know, advertise what your Twitter handle is. Let them know so that they can follow you. Also, taking a picture of you? That's important too. Make sure that you have a picture in your profile. You start with that little egg, change it to a profile picture. I think they're doing that right now. When you post a picture, you have the ability to tag up to 10 people. When you tag 10 people on Twitter, those people will get a notification that they've been tagged, which is great because lots of times when you tag people in photos, they'll retweet the picture and then all of their followers can see it. So it's almost like a network when you do that. Okay, our Twitter chat on Monday night is from 9 to 10. How do you participate? You go online, you search for hashtag ALEdChat, you read the questions that are posted, and then you answer, and you make sure that you use the hashtag. So the first question will post as Q1, and when people answer, they'll put A1 in their responses. And then after a few minutes, we ask question 2. And so it will say Q2, and then the question, and then when people answer, they put A2, and so on. And that way you can figure out which response is going to which question. Share positive messages. Holly shared a quote of the day. You might have a saying, a motto, a school motto. You can share that. Quotes from other educators, quotes from leaders, anything positive and uplifting. Make sure, too, that when you've been tagged or tweeted, that you retweet it and that you respond. Include comments on that. And then also, I always get asked this question. Should I have a personal account and a professional account? That's a tough question that a lot of people struggle with. And so I'm just going to share with you a couple things to think about. If you have a personal and a professional, that's two accounts you got to keep up with. And you just told me you didn't have time. Okay? So that's two accounts to keep up with, seriously. The other thing is, if you're going to be tweeting something from your personal account that people shouldn't be reading anyway, you shouldn't be on Twitter, okay? The other thing is that when you post your from your professional account, sprinkle in some personal information because you don't want to seem like a robot on the other end of the screen. Anybody can tweet out links to blogs and EdWeek and ASCD. They can tweet all those kind of things. But when you read something about somebody that says they went and ran this morning or dropped their kids off in carpool or, you know, pulled vegetables from the garden, you read that every now and then, you really feel like you have more of a personal connection with that person. And it helps you see that as humans, we have a lot more in common than just the profession of education. And then you've got to advertise. If you're not good with bragging on your school or bragging on your teachers or your kids, get an assistant principal, get a teacher leader, get a secretary, somebody to help you, to remind you. Share your hashtag at open house. If you have TV screens around your building, share it there. If you send newsletters home, make sure you share it there. If you print programs for athletic events, you can put it on there. If you have a fine arts program going at your school and you print off a program for that, you can put it there. We host a curriculum night every year at our school, and we share this with our parents. So at our curriculum night, we have a practice gym and a cafeteria that are close by. And so we have 4 30-minute sessions that happen in the cafeteria, and concurrently we have a curriculum fair going on in the practice gym. So parents can go back and forth depending on which session they want to go to or if they want to go to the curriculum fair. And so we have a huge screen that's up in the cafeteria, and we have TV monitors in the gym, and we have our Twitter feed running. So we have students and teachers in the curriculum fair telling parents, hey, come to our table. Come see what the Engineering Academy's doing. Come find out about our Finance Academy. And parents are sharing things that they're hearing. We're tweeting the speakers who are doing the presentations. That's another option. Also, let local businesses know. You know, you have businesses that want to be involved and want to partner with you, and they're always looking for ways to do that. Some of these businesses are definitely on social media to promote their businesses, and they'll help promote your school too. So make sure that you share it with local businesses as well. Okay, we were just talking about the egg in your profile. If you're on Twitter, I encourage you to take a look at your profile. Because you want to know that when people see your profile, they know who you are, they know what you're about. So if you have a school hashtag, be sure to include that. If you have a school website or a school blog, a school Facebook page even, make sure you include that in your profile. Maybe you're on Facebook but not on Twitter. Check your description on Facebook too. Are you telling everything that you need to tell? You know, are you a committed school? Are you a school of excellence? You know, what are those things that you want people to know about you? Make sure that's included in your profile. If it's your professional account, describe yourself a little bit. Tell something personal maybe. Maybe your mom, maybe your dad, a coach. Let people know. Okay. And these are four resources that I wanted to share with you that are very, very helpful when you're trying to tell your school story. The first one is TweetDeck.com, okay? What TweetDeck.com does is it creates columns on your screen that you can organize by hashtag, okay? So you'll have a column that will be your home feed, and that's like your home feed on Facebook. It's your home feed of everybody that you follow. That will be a column. Then you can have a column for notifications. So anytime somebody tweets you or mentions you or retweets one of your tweets, that will show up in the notifications column. What's great about having that is you can make sure that you respond to those tweets. You can say thanks for sharing. You can agree or disagree. You can make a comment. Make sure that you always respond to those. The other website that I want to share with you is called Canva.com. It is a free site. It has free resources where you can create your own graphics. So you may have seen those pictures that have quotes on them. Sometimes you're looking for free photographs to use in a flyer, in a newsletter. You can easily create them on Canva. Once you create your account, the great thing is that the pictures are editable. Have y'all ever created a picture for something and then you went back and noticed that you misspelled a word and then you had to start all over again? With Canva, it saves your photo online and you can edit it. So maybe you have a flyer that you're going to use every month, you're going to use every year, and you can just change the dates on it. It's a great site and it's real easy. The other one is something you can download to your cell phone. It's called Word Swag. It creates positive quotes. So if you hear a teacher or a student say something that you want to share, you can type it into Word Swag. It'll make it look all cool. You can include your school hashtag, post that picture to Twitter. Pictures get retweeted and seen more than just the words. And then the last one is called PicStitch. And with this app, you can make a collage of pictures. So if you have three or four pictures from one classroom, you can use PicStitch to make a collage of those pictures into one picture. Okay, so these are my top four resources. There's other ones, but if you're just getting started, you're looking for ways to expand telling your school story, I would say check these out because these are very, very helpful. And so in my years of playing sports and coaching sports, one thing I know to be true, a team takes on the personality of the coach. My husband is a former college athlete too. We talk about this a lot. It applies to organizations. It applies to family units. It applies to education. It applies to classrooms. It applies to teams. We talk about this a lot. A team takes on the personality of the coach. And so when you think of yourself as the coach at your school, what personality do you want your teachers to take on? Because whatever it is, that's what they're going to take on. Okay? We got to model what it is that we want to see. And so think of yourself as the Twitter coach. Okay? You're going to set the tone. Your superintendent, who is the leader, the coach of this entire district, who has, I don't know how much time y'all have, but I bet she has less of it. She's finding time to tweet. I know that she loves Alabama football. I know that she goes to lots of events at the school. She visits schools. She's very visible and very active. And it starts with her for the district. And it's going to start with you guys in your school. So I want to encourage you to remember that as you go back and maybe try to get this started or going or greater at your school. And I love this picture. Are you going to be like the ladies in the front row? Or are you going to be like the ladies in the third row? Because I'm going to tell you, it is a ride. But it is a great one. I want to let you know that as you start this or continue your journey, I want to be there to help you. I've got my contact information up. I want to share that with you. We have done Twitter parties at our school to try to get teachers signed on. We've had contests. We played Twitter bingo. You know, if you need anything, do not hesitate to reach out. I'd love for you to read some of my blog posts about Twitter on my blog. I have all the resources there with pictures to give you some ideas. Something that we do an annual Twitter party. And so at the end of the month, I'll do a lunch and learn with all of our brand new teachers at our school. So they'll come and brown bag their lunch. I'll provide dessert and we'll talk about just using social media safely and appropriately and how we use it at Hoover High School. And then the next week or so, we'll have our Twitter party. So I spend a day in one of our conference rooms. I have cookies. I make it fun. People can stop by. And this year, we're going to award a prize to the department who has the highest percentage of attendees at the Twitter party. That'll kick off our Twitter bingo game. Last year we did this. I shared about it on my blog, and I saw a Twitter bingo pop up all over the country where people were using the resource and trying it. And so there were, you could win first prize by completing a row or a column or diagonal. You'd go into a drawing for $10, and then if you won the grand prize, and you had to complete the whole board to go in the drawing for the grand prize, you won $10 plus lunch. So I got a menu from a local restaurant, and I said, pick out what you want, and I'm going to deliver lunch to you in your classroom. And that was great. And we had a lot of people that really, they may have done it just for the opportunity to get the free lunch, but it was really cool to see the number of people who participated with that Twitter bingo. And so I'm sure that you guys are probably way more creative than I, and will come up with some really cool ideas. And so I hope that you will share those things on Twitter. Share that as part of your school story. It's a fun way for teachers to learn. It's a fun way to brag on your teachers and your school and your kids. Y'all, there are too many messages that are negative about public education. And when we share our positive messages, we can dilute those negative messages. And I want to give you one example. We have a reporter in our area who has not always been a friend to Hoover High School and has often reported negative things. And so when Holly and I started tweeting and sharing things that were going on in the classroom, we had an event, you know, come up at our school. And so this reporter had been following us and seeing all of our tweets throughout the year of what was going on in our school. And so when this event occurred, instead of sharing it or instead of turning it into a story, he sent a direct message and asked, hey, is there anything to this? And it was great, and it was so cool because he had seen all those messages about what was happening in our school, which made him question this negative thing that he had heard. And it seemed kind of insignificant because it was one negative message among all these positive messages, okay? So I want to open it up for questions and see if anybody has anything that I can help with or any questions that you have. I know you've been sitting a long time. Who thinks that they can tweet about their school? I just want to say, I'm curious. Okay. No questions? Okay. if you think there's something they... Thank y'all so much. Y'all are wonderful. You're doing awesome things in your district. Keep doing it. I'm going to keep looking for tweets from you guys. Thank you.